Welcome to us. Lazer may be the future of OS, but OS is also a game with close ties to its history. That's why you see previous generations of default skins built into Lazer, and the oldest one is being added in this update, Retro.
So the retro skin is basically bringing back the original pre-classic era of OS. This is how OS used to look in 2007, and now everyone can experience it, at least in the gameplay part for now. There's a few elements in the skin which do come from further forward in history. Those have been chosen where the element was added before 2013, but kind of is required to make the skin look complete. And there's still some work ongoing to add back things like combo fire. The real fine details of those skins will come back online bit by bit. I think also combo bursts, having that would, you know, add back that extra bit of flair for this kind of skin, retro skin.
Skins in Lazer are built from components, each modifiable from the skin editor, and two new components were added today. First is an Argon rendition of the old Judgment counter. Pretty self-explanatory, it counts your judgments. And second is the aim error meter, showing exactly how on target your clicks are. This has a few visual settings for you to mess with, but the important option is here at the bottom. Absolute means like if you click exactly here on a circle, it'll mark that same spot on the component. And normalized might be better for broad aim analysis. Think of this arrow as the direction from the previous object. So if you aim a bit short, it'll mark close to the base of the arrow. And if you aim too far, it'll mark closer to the top. You can then look at this component during a stream or a jump section to see if you're more frequently undershooting or overshooting your aim.
I think at this point we need to better expose these new components because it's kind of hard to get to right now, and you need to know the exact component name, right? It's what called default aim error meter or something.
Yeah, and it doesn't help that this one's hidden under like a mode specific layer. Sound effects were added to the rank display component recently, and because of stuff like this, people complained.
In an effort to fix that, we made an initial change and pushed it out to Tachyon, where if you switch from A to S, but you're only in the S range for 500 milliseconds and then drop back to A, that would not count. And that worked really well. But then people were saying like, oh, it's no longer changing in real time. It takes like 1 second before the rank updates. And to a lot of people, that felt like it was actually bugging out, like it wasn't working properly. So now the behavior has changed. It can immediately switch to a rank, but after that switch, it has to wait up to, I think, 1 second or 1.5 seconds before it will switch again.
I see further down on the changelog, fix approach circle being less round than intended. How is the circle not perfectly round already?
You tell me. And no one's noticed all these years. Like I don't know if I should say this, but that's how it is on stable as well. And for that reason, we've only fixed it for Argon and Triangles, I think. The classic skin is still not round.
If the sight of a long note gives you nightmares, you'll be happy to know that Song Select now supports search by LN percentage. LN equals 0 will give you maps without hold notes. LN equals 100 will give you maps with 100% hold notes. And you can find anything in between if you really want to. Mania also added the option for secondary keybinds. And this setting, which does stuff like giving the first object in hidden an approach circle, now applies to Tycho because of situations like this. This is a pretty niche situation, so even most Tycho players probably never encountered it, but I'd be willing to bet that you have encountered another bug with the first object in maps.
Oh, this is a big one. And I'm not just saying that because it was me that was the one that fixed it. To start playback of the audio track, because of the way sound devices work, there's a very slight delay. And during that delay, the game used to freeze. I noticed that the way we're doing interpolation of time was kind of frame rate dependent, which means that for people running at higher frame rates, they would see more of a stutter. If you were running at 60 FPS, it would actually look correct.
So it worked for like basically nobody.
Yeah, nobody, exactly. And that has now been fixed. The fix is a bit of a hack, basically interpolating time better to make sure that you can't see that stutter. So it was a matter of figuring out how long we wanted to drift the offset back into the correct timing window. Most people could not notice the difference, we're still getting accurate hits. So yeah, it's in a good state now.
Grouping by collections was added last update, and that revealed a very blatant issue with Song Select. Maps couldn't appear in multiple groups. So as of now, that's been fixed.
upcoming filter slash group modes rely on this. So it was kind of like a bottleneck for us. We had to get this fixed to add in more functionality. Also along the way, I think this fixes a lot of bugs with display. Like if you opened up a bitmap which was split out into multiple groups, it would kind of bug out previously, and now it works much better.
Grouping by rank achieved was also added last update. This seems straightforward enough. If the highest rank you've gotten on a map is a B, put it in the B section. What should happen in a case like this though?
In stable, if you're logged out, you can actually choose any username at the results screen. It was kind of like an arcade-y thing where, you know, when you get a high score in an arcade, you would put in your initials. Because of that, it means that any scores imported from stable, we don't really know if they were played by the local user or if they were downloaded by the local user. We don't store an ID or anything. There's no way to verify that. So until now, we would just assume that they weren't played by the local user. This change basically flips that the other way around, where if we can't verify a score is from an online user, then we assume it's by the local user.
Hello, Flight.
Hey.
So this update adds a new icon for every mod, including the ones that obviously had no designs, but also redoing the ones that had designs. What was the design concept behind the new icons?
So if you notice, like our design team for Argon is lines, basically based on the cursor trails. When you do a cursor trail, there's like lines. So I decided to play along with the lines concept. So like when I created the gameplay screen, you see there's a lot of like line-based motifs, including the score. From that, iconography went into the lines concept. And then when I designed the new mods, also, you know, the design is line base.
And how did you decide the contents of each icon?
A lot of the icons are like very, very abstract. I think that's like very intentional because it's really hard to make a lot of the icons very descriptive. I have to like try every single mod and try to get a basic understanding of what the mods actually do.
Well, I think they turned out pretty good. And that's all I have to really ask about right now. One of these days we have to make like a laser specific design video because it sounds like you have a lot of thoughts on it.
I have so many things to say. These people just simply don't know the amount of effort I put into this design because everyone just see the outcome of the design and people are like, oh yeah, that's like a 5 minutes work. No, it's a 5 months effort, you know, but...
Let's go through a few multiplayer changes. First, when spectating, you'll now hear audio from whichever player is enlarged. Previously, you would only hear the first player, no matter what. Over in playlists, there's a new pinned display for stuff like spotlights, which are permanently at the top. And the UI for playlists and multiplayer have become slightly more compact. The initial goal here was to make it possible to see more elements on mobile devices, where space is especially limited, but it also affects desktop builds, showing more of the contents that you'd actually care about.
One of the most common complaints we had about the bitmap listing was that in stable you could quickly download bitmaps by double clicking on a row, and that was not feasible in laser. So instead, holding down shift now gives you the stable behavior. First click will download, or if it's already downloaded, will take you straight to the map at song select.
There's also one more multiplayer thing to talk about, but it doesn't exist yet. Matchmaking, or rather quick play is the official name. It's coming next release, right?
Correct.
What's the current status of this?
What is the current status? So the matchmaking algorithm part isn't done. The UI is not finished, so everything kind of looks a bit jank. But the general flow is there, the game works, you can already play a game with people, and yeah.
I'm in the queue.
Okay, so if I begin queuing, you should see me flying around on that screen.
I see Wang, yes. And a very tiny version of myself.
So this screen is kind of like the... I've already done a bit of design work on this screen, and the idea is that this is like the lobby screen for matchmaking. And I want to make it an experience where anyone can enjoy it, even if you're not here to actually play. I want the screen to like show the process of matches coming together as a visualization, so anyone can just come here and chill.
Good luck.
Yeah, so down the bottom, that's kind of the current stage, what's going on. So we go into bitmap select, and now we can choose our bitmap.
We're survival dance lovers.
It's the fastest map to play, what can I say? Oh, so this is... We should have chosen different maps, because this is the random select.
Very dramatic map selection.
I'm playing with a tablet, I'm still not used to it.
I don't think you can be used to this map, to be honest.
But yeah, so the idea here is that like it just scrolls through the scores, and then this is going to the next round, so we're now in round two.
Okay, I think that's enough for a teaser. We'll talk about quick play in much more detail next update.
It's feeling good though, right? Like it already feels like you could have fun with this. Like we've played a couple of dev sessions of it and yeah, it's been good. I will say that like if you're interested in testing the system, we'll be rolling this out to Tachyon for testing in the next week or so.
I'll be part of the Tachyon testing crowd.
I hope to be as well. Hopefully not using tablet because I think I still prefer mouse.